Hey guys, welcome back to the shop. We have a pretty cool project today. I'm forging my first bearded hatchet. Starting out with a block of 4140 steel. And I'm making a mark 1 inch from the end of the billet, which is going to be the end that the pole is, or the butt of the axe. And of course, centering that up in the middle of our center line of our billet. This center punch mark is going to show me where to start my punch when I pull it out of the forge. And I like to punch the eye from both sides, so I'm going to make two marks. I'm starting out slowly and carefully to make sure that I have the punch started where it needs to go. And my billet was actually a little bit cockeyed and not sitting quite straight up and down, so I had to fix that real quick. Once I have the punch started, I'll move to my lower striking surface, which gives me a lot more ability to get more power into the swing of the hammer and get more work done quicker and easier. I'm turning the billet around each time, which is so that any sideways alignment of your punch is mitigated by turning it back and forth like that, thereby keeping it centered, at least theoretically. So at this point I started punching from the other side of the billet after I'd gotten about halfway through. Started to drift off center a little bit, and sometimes I guess punching from the other side is one of the quickest ways to mitigate that. At least that's what I found. Now that both sides have been punched through mostly, I'm driving the punch all the way through, and we'll get the eye started here. Now that the eye is punched through, I can start drifting it. And drifting the eye is to open it up and forge it into the closer to the final dimensions that the axe handle is going to fit into. Now that I've got the eye started, I'm going to go ahead and forge in, I guess what you would call the beard of the hatchet, by making that transition between the main part of the axe and the bit, where that blade drops down in the front. Here I've reset the drift into the eye, and I'll start forging out the cheeks, thinning those down, and on the lower portion of the axe, forging them out so that they drop below the rest of the material. This gives us greater surface area for the handle to contact when it's mounted in the axe, which provides a more durable and long-lasting union between the axe and the handle. Here I'm continuing to drift the eye to open it up further, trying to use these pieces of steel to protect the cheeks that are dropped down there and the beginning of the bearded portion, but it didn't really work that well. So we have a lot of steel to forge out here into the bit, and the press is definitely useful for that. You'll notice the eye is close to finished dimensions, but I won't finish that out until I've got the bit almost completely forged. Now that I have the axe forged down most of the way, I can use my hammer to even out things and get it closer to the finished thickness. I went ahead and used my press to get things nice and flat, fairly close up towards the eye. Here again, I'm trying to finish the eye out and using a system that really did not work. Eventually, I was able to simply go between a couple of spots in the swage block and get the eye drifted the rest of the way. Here I'm working on evening up the eye and getting it parallel to the bit of the axe. Those have to be straight in line with each other. And then of course the edge or the bit has to be in the center line of the handle as you're looking edge on. So doing a bit of straightening here. So there's our finished forged hatchet, and it's looking a little bit rough, but we have everything we need there to complete a nice bearded hatchet. This is a little bit more difficult, I'm finding, than a regular hatchet, but it was a fun process and I'm enjoying learning how to build these. If you guys are enjoying the video and the channel, consider subscribing. Sure appreciate that. Appreciate you watching here. I like to clean up the profile and get everything straightened up before heat treat. That way the only grinding left to do after heat treat is the actual bevel for the edge. So that's looking pretty good there. You notice that the edge is still quite thick, but this being 4140 in a water quench, it'll harden up just fine. So we're going to go ahead and normalize this several times before we harden it. And this is important because it relieves all the stress in the steel that we've created during the forging process. After several cycles, we can go ahead and quench it. And you'll notice I'm agitating the axe head vigorously in the water, and this is important. Otherwise, it will form a vapor jacket, which will slow the cooling process and potentially give you a bad quench. Let's go ahead and temper this out here a couple of times. So it's the next day, and now that the hatchet's all tempered and ready to go, we can clean up the surface with a wire brush, and it gives us a real nice finish, takes all the scale off and reveals that neat forged finish of the steel. I think I said a minute ago that there wasn't any grinding after the heat treat process except for the edge, and I forgot about the pull of the hatchet. I want to grind off the decarburized layer there and get a good surface, since that can be used as a hammer. So grind in the bevel here, and we'll start by doing basically a flat grind, and then at a certain point when we have, I don't know, maybe 70 thousandths, 80 thousandths on the edge, we'll finish it out with a convex grind. This will give us the best edge strength and also the edge profile that will give us the best results with chopping wood. Got a piece of ash here to make the handle out of, and I'll use my template, making it a little wider than the template is. I started making my own handles because it's almost impossible to find axe and hatchet handles that have the eye size that I want. Typically your store-bought handles and store-bought axes and hatchets have a pretty thin and small eye, and I want to kind of make that oversized a little bit so that you have a more material at that point. Give you a stronger tool that will last longer. So making your own handles from scratch anyway is kind of part of the gig. Whatever it takes to get the best quality product, I guess. So I'm just going to thin down the portion of the handle that's going into the eye, and this will take a little bit of time to fit because we're going to tap that in there, see where it's hanging up, see what's not fitting, and we'll carefully remove some material and then try it again. Obviously that needs a fair amount removed. Just using my knife here to remove that extra material. You can use a variety of different tools to do that. So you can see we're getting a closer fit. This is after several times of checking it and removing some material. And we've got a little bit more to do here. Use a little rasp here just to smooth things up and get close to the final finish. So it was looking really good, and then that happened. So obviously I'm not going to be able to use this handle, but I decided to go ahead and finish mounting it for a temporary handle. I don't have any other wood at this point. I have some hickory coming, but it's not here yet. So that's a bummer, but this will allow us to at least test out the hatchet, and then I'll rehang it, clean it up, and get it ready for sale. Once I get that new handle wood in. Let's put a nice edge on this, and that broad bit there makes it pretty easy to sharpen up. It's pretty fun. Alright, so now for some chopping. And I will say that I'm really happy with the way this performs. Once it has a good handle on it, it's going to be a great little tool for any outdoorsman. Got some black walnut here, chopping in different grains, splitting. This here I'm cutting against the grain, and same here. It's just it's a fun little axe to use. Really do like that bearded design. Well, that's it for today, guys. I really appreciate you watching. I hope you enjoyed this little build. I sure did. As always, appreciate it, and we will see you on the next video.